Hey everybody, Brian and Rachel Goodlay here for an episode of Right Now. It's kind of a special one. We're actually announcing a new brand.
Yes, that we kind have. Of.
Sort of. It's like a getting to know a friend you've casually known, but better, I guess.
Sure. We're here today to talk about Jacques Urban. So we've been carrying, well, originally J. Urban.
Yep.
It was actually our very first ink brand we ever had, the only ink brand we had from day one.
That's right.
In November 2009, when we started this whole thing. They were the very first people to sell to us, to start Goulet Pens. We're very forever grateful for them for that. There
Absolutely.
Were like 30 colors, and then slowly over time we built more. Mm-hmm. So it's been J. Urban for the last, as long as we've...
9.5 years?
Well, that we've been around. They've been
sure.
that much
oh,
longer.
Yeah. Absolutely.
About a year or two, I think it was maybe a year ago. Was it a year ago? 2 years ago? They started rebranding, and we started seeing just Urban. They dropped the J. And then Jacques Urban in the 1670 and the 1798, mm-hmm. the shimmering anniversary colors.
Yeah.
So we're like, that's interesting. What's the rebranding all about? Well, turns out they were on the cusp of launching a new exclusive Jacques Urban collection.
Yes.
And we are super privileged, proud, honored, whatever, to be the exclusive U.S. retailer for the Jacques Urban premium collection. So
that's pretty cool.
It's very cool. And it's just, it's really cool to come full circle like that.
Now, to caveat that, that doesn't mean we're going to have an exclusive on the 1798
no.
and the 1670.
You can still
inks.
Get those elsewhere.
So that's still part of the collection. It's just the new stuff we're talking
and
about
And at least
here.
For the next year, it might not be a permanent thing, but at least for the next year.
Exclusive introduction, we'll say.
It's currently available at, I want to say, 4 or 5 different locations worldwide. I know
mm-hmm.
there's someone in Australia, someone in
Paris.
Paris, maybe Japan or Korea, somewhere like that. It's
yeah.
not widely available yet.
Yeah.
We're pretty sure this line will be new to most of you. We don't have the full collection. We're starting
Correct.
Out with all the ink because, you know, we love ink.
Come on.
A good selection of stationery, some glass pens. There are some other lines. There are some writing instruments. They're still working on those. They're not quite ready for us yet, so we don't have those right now.
We've seen some. We've given them feedback, so it's
yeah.
something that we'll consider in the future.
It's in process.
Yeah, but for now, we have plenty to talk about.
And there are some leather goods as well.
Yeah.
So yeah, let's talk about the ink first.
Okay.
So there are 10 standard colors. So by standard, I mean they're not shimmering. And they're not scented, so just
Correct.
Your conventional colors. Similar bottle to the 1670 and the 1798,
mm-hmm.
but they don't have like the wax and like that whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
Still a beautiful glass premium bottle. The price is pretty good for what you're getting. It's comparable to the, actually a little bit less than the 1670 and the 1798.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nice outer box, kind of shows you what color you're getting. And then the custom label as well.
Yep.
So there are 10 colors. And they're, I'd say they're fairly on the saturated side. Like, kind of like if you'd look at the 1670 and the 1798, if you didn't have the shimmer.
Took the shimmer out.
Yeah, yeah. You compare those to the Urban line, which is a little more in the watercolor
Yeah,
family,
they tend to be a little
you
more
know.
Muted, a little less saturated. It's,
yeah.
it's a little heavier saturated.
So these
those.
Are heavier in the saturation side. So these are just at a glance your 10 colors. And they're in French. And my French is not great, so I'm not quite ready to say them all out loud. Some interesting ones, I mean, the teal is, I think, just spot on. Teal has been
really
popular.
Yeah.
Really pretty blue.
Purple's really nice.
The purple's really nice. The orange is very vibrant.
Mm-hmm.
Nice deep green as well. The black is a good black. Like, it's a deep black.
I'm actually pretty pleased with the whole palette they've
yeah.
come up with here. I
and the yellow is very usable. So you might notice yellow is kind of like their color,
mm-hmm.
As well as red and blue.
It's more of like a harvest gold.
I was going to say like a mustard yellow, but that sounds way better than what I said.
I believe that was the popular color of the 70s was harvest gold.
So these are available in the 50ml bottles, as we mentioned, as well as standard international long cartridges. The only ones we carry in this size currently are the Edelstein.
Yeah.
So it's nice to have another offering,
mm-hmm.
all 10 colors, pretty good price as well, and you get 7. Then there's also, I'm saying Amelot, I'm sorry. Two different.
Sorry, it's a lot to remember on this one.
Two different ink sets. This is the like the lunar, the moon, I guess.
There's like a day set and a night set.
There's like a day
set.
And a night. So this is the night set, a little darker, and
mm-hmm.
then the day set has the other
different colors.
Five inks, so
yeah.
a little more vibrant. So these are 15 mil bottles. It'll be an interesting experience filling your filling pen. Them, I would recommend using a
syringe of some
syringe
kind,
or the Peniter, the snorkel or the pen fill or something like that.
For sure.
But these are glass as well. So this is a really nice gift.
I mean, the packaging itself, very, very French, very European packaging, looks really nice, really crisp. That's all I can say about that.
So bottles, cartridges, we'll have samples in a couple days, and the ink sets. You can also get the ink as part of the glass dip pen sets. So this comes with a glass dip pen and a matching ink.
Yeah,
and these three colors.
And these glass pens are different than the other Jerabon glass pens that we've had
years
and years. Just the styling is different. They're still handmade. The style is a little, let me see if I can.
I haven't written with it yet to see if it's like finer or.
Well, it's tough to say because they're handmade, so I'm trying not to like rip it out. There we go. Okay. So the glass nib is a little smaller. It's got kind of a small tapered shape. It doesn't have any kind of twist to it or anything like that, like the bigger ones do. And then the edge is actually kind of cleaved, so it's got a little bit of a point to it, which is cool because we don't have any glass pens that have that going on. So these are going to be handmade. Each one's going to be a little different.
Mm-hmm.
The tip size will be just a little bit different on every one because it's handmade.
And there is black, red, and blue, and they each come with the matching ink.
Yep.
And a lot of the products have this little really tiny booklet. Like, you might need a magnifying glass depending on your eyesight.
It's a surprisingly informative booklet.
It does. It gives you a whole history of the company.
Yeah.
Talks about kind of how they've evolved. You got the little, like, here's the ink colors. We need to talk about the scented colors.
We will. We're going to have a lot of this information on the product pages themselves. But it's nice if it's a gift thing and you give it to somebody, they can see more or less the full catalog.
Yeah.
In this tiny little book.
So we did mention the, where is it? Did you bring one?
That is a scented one, yeah.
So there are four scented colors, and we do currently carry scented ink, the Diatramentis scented. Is that the only one?
I believe that's the only one now, yeah.
Yeah. Urban does make another one. We have a little sampler set.
They had a sampler set.
No, we do carry the sampler set. We don't have the full bottles.
Yes.
The difference with these are very high-end perfume or cologne smelling.
It literally smells like you've opened a bottle of cologne.
So it's not like and I think it lasts a little bit longer. I think ultimately if you're writing a letter and you mail it to someone, it probably won't smell by the time they get it. But
it's going to be up in the air. But I would have more confidence about these lasting than some of the other scents.
How would you describe this?
Oh gosh, I'm so bad at describing scents. I don't know. It smells very good though.
For those of you who end up getting ink all over your fingers, or some of you on your faces, I've seen your pictures. At least you'll smell good.
Yeah, Ghouli Nation, we know.
We know who you are. So the four colors are here for the scented inks. Two of them are more on the perfumey, like the floral side, and two I'd say are more on like the cologne, like the masculine side.
Yeah.
Just as far as like.
And it's four distinctly different scents too.
Yes, and I think as far as colors go, they're really similar to some of the other colors.
Yeah.
They're not exactly the same, but they're pretty close.
Yeah.
So they're really nice, and if
you end up with a bunch of bottles, the scented ones have gold writing on the top and the other ones have silver.
And different words.
True. If that matters.
The essential collection and
the perfume collection. There you go.
So that's pretty cool.
And then we got stationery.
So there's two sizes, a C6 and a Visit. Visit was a new term for me.
What does Visit mean? Because I actually don't know.
It's the specific size that I don't have memorized, but you can find on our product pages.
Let me see if
so these are a box set of 25 cards and envelopes, and the cards
the
you can
sizes.
See are colored,
like colored edges.
On the edges.
That's cool.
Which is really cool. We've seen some factories making these. Mm-hmm. In some cases, they're hand painted, and
this is like an old world kind of craft that they do with paper. They'll either do borders or edges or something like that.
And then you got the cut corners too. And then they come with a matching envelope.
Super classy.
And again, the choices are, yellow, blue, and red. And they each have a little subtle different design. And the whole Urban thing, the Jacques Urban, like there's an ocean theme. He was a not a voyager.
like a traveler, like a tradesman on the sea, on the high seas. Not a pirate, legally, like a good one. What do you call those? Oh my gosh. Like a trader, a trader.
Yeah.
An ocean faring trader.
The word is somewhere, and you guys are going to tell us all in the comments. So there's a bit of a nautical theme going on, but also like little, it's interesting, little letters. Like these are little like cursive O's, and these look like U's, and these are I's. So like vowels and cursive, but kind of looking nautical in a way. So that's kind of cool.
It is cool.
And they're fountain pen friendly, we made sure.
And the edging on the cards matches the inside of the envelope too. So it's just like these nice little touches. So like the red ones are red on the edge and they have the red matching envelopes. Pretty cool.
Yeah.
And we tested out the fountain pen friendliness because of course that matters a lot. And we found it to be very, very good.
So, and these are very well priced. They're comparable to, you know, an original Crown Mill type set.
Yeah.
Is that everything?
I think we've covered everything,
wow.
At least that we're starting off with. So we'd love to get your feedback on it. We have way more technical details and stuff like that that are going to be on the product pages on our website.
The line may expand over time. We're interested in your feedback as well as we get to know it.
And part of the reason that Jacques wanted to work with us, not Jacques the person, he's long gone, but Jacques Urban, that they wanted to work with us is because you all are such an engaged community and you give us such great feedback. So we would love to know, you know, especially if just as a first impression on this video, or especially if you actually end up buying these products, using them, giving us that feedback, because they've been amazingly receptive so far into our feedback, and then they'll be engaged with yours as well. So please give us that feedback. You can give it in the comments. Be sure to like, subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching another episode of Right Now with us, and right on.